Baldwin's still missing. It's scary. Okay. Eustace was only gone a day. Or week, apparently. Okay. Smithy. I really need to be increasing some gear here. Jason, you're a decent front line. So there you go. Useless as a dog guy, he's pretty good. Oh right, you need to level first. Fair enough. What's it take to increase this more deeds, of course. Oh look, reduces the cost. Lol. See ya, Sean. Get your weapon. Not the armor though. Running a little low on money here. Okay. We're gonna have to stop there. 4,000 gold is a bit low. Couple highwaymen and another bounty hunter. Meh. And just out of curiosity, 5 accuracy, minus 2 dodge, plus 25% heal skills, minus 10% max HP. Vestal only. Okay, that depends who we take along with us. So, let's see here. You can do either. You have to pray. Okay, fine. You should be okay with either. You can be there. Okay. Head over to the tavern. What am I using next? God, I need money for supplies. I can't do anymore. Unless I sell shit, which I definitely could. That's an extra 1,000. Can't have 2. Okay. Well. Get Krug in there. I'd like to de-stress generic carrot. One. Krug, Jason, Rogue. Useless. Work. That's the necromancer room battles. It's a short one. Oh yeah, healer. I don't really have any healers though. Like I don't have any arbalists. I could bring Sphinx. Let's do that. Let's bring Sphinx. I think backpack for you. It's best I've got. Because I don't have any arbalists, I don't have many of the occultists. In fact, I think generic carrot's actually the only one I've got. Yeah. Not many healers to play with. Anything equipment-wise for you? Blood skill chance, give that to you.
Hell yeah.
Give you stun skill chance and that. bleed skills. I don't have any bleed skills. Can't even get you a bleed skill. God damn it. Well, should I go for the necromancer again? We have a healer. We got Blight. We got a tank who's, not the cleanest. That can stun Zealous Accusation. Straight up attack. You have Rampart and Crush, but you've got Retribution in case we need help with it. Well, I can sell a trinket still, or two. I mean, I wouldn't mind getting rid of this. I don't have many highwaymen that I use, and that'd be another 1,000. That one's only 750. Blew. Yeah, maybe one more run of something, and then Necromancer, I guess. It's just a lot of these are poopy. Need deeds. Medium, 5 deeds, uncommon. It's a medium, though. I don't have much money. I think the only choice that I've really got here is either scouting that place out for a really awkward ring. Warrior's cap's not that bad. All right, we'll do this. Six, an 8, and a shovel. 60 gold. Oh, and Dark's dungeon crashed. That's what I get for alt tabbing, I guess. Awkward. Relaunching. Auto saves, right? I think it does.
Ruin has come to our family.
Yeah, it auto-saved. Week 10. Ugh.
The fiends must be driven by.
Okay, cool.
And what better place to begin?
Had auto-saved at a perfect time.
Of our noble line. Even the cold.
Okay, Rod of Shovels
seems bent on preventing passage.
I don't have any keys, so we're ignoring that. I can't really guarantee a specific class, it just kind of is whatever shows up. I I mean, the best you could do is the caravan, upgrade it so you get more people every week and just basically like roll the die more, you know?
Into the mud.
There you go. Plus 30 blight skill chance, plus 30 stun skill chance. Nice. Secret room would be fantastic. Just saying. Gonna say that should be wearing fuck. Take her with your hands.
Without tools of iron, you must rely on flesh and indefatigable purpose.
Not many room battles going on though. It's like all corridor and look at this battle. Jesus. Never mind, they're all at the end. A double chemistry set. Ugh. Okay, hold on. Do it again. It'll be fine.
A fortune.
Wow, you made 25 gold. Impressive. Thanks. Well done, Rogue. Guess I can't complain. Money is money, you know, but... man. Damn it. Not the best round. Are all skeletons. Touch him, hopefully the blight will kill him. Nice.
Woohoo!
I just got these assholes, he's gonna go for a stun. Yep, that's fine. Both of these guys are okay up front. Stun you right back, buddy. Arrgh. You too.
Surges as the enemy crumbles. Is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Damn it. Start at the last second.
Ancient traps lie in wait.
Keeps happening.
Unsprung and thirsting for blood.
for him, so that way if he hits you, your counter might kill him. Of course, he won't target you, though. Yeah, inventory space isn't a problem anymore. Yay! Yeah. Go for a judgment. And him. I'll have 2 health left.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Now he'll be dead. And you're dead.
This expedition at least promises success.
Another battle ahead, though.
Glittering gold, trinkets, and baubles. Paid for in blood.
Oh, this is an easy battle, though. Upgrading the coach for 4 heroes at a time required 20 deeds, was it? It was something, a lot of something that I didn't have much of at all. Yeah, I guess him. Doesn't really matter. Well, it's usually an easy encounter, okay?
Another one falls. Another abomination cleansed from our lands. The light,
and another room
the
battle.
Promise of safety.
Should really heal. Yeah, alright.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
To heal. Everybody kind of needs a little bit. Yay, one. And, yeah.
Slowly, gently, this is how a life is taken. As victories mount, so too will resistance.
And one of these is a room battle.
Ambushed by foul inventory.
Damn, really? Oh, Krug's hopeless. God damn it. Have some food, Krug. I don't have a key. No, don't do it, Krug. No. Fuck. He can't help you. That's 6 damage. You only have 10 health. Yeah. Don't do it, Krug. I'm ignoring it.
match is struck. A blazing star is born.
It's gonna end up putting him in at death's door and eventually killing him. Alright, might just kill him here.
Or cowardice.
Yep.
This is no place for the weak.
Bye, Krug. Death by poison. I think helpless just increases the amount of stress that you take. Basically, it just means that you failed your stress check. And that won't really do much for anybody. So, vapors for the riposte.
In the shadows whisper of conspiracy.
Which health do you have? 8? Guess. Don't want you marked anymore though. Our Vestal's like sitting there at full health. That's actually okay. A free move. Cool. He's gonna die at the start of his turn, so I guess go for incision just for the damage. Doesn't matter, he's gonna blight to death. Doesn't matter. God. Whoa. Oh, right.
These
yeah.
Nightmarish creatures Kirk can died. Be felled. They can be beaten.
Yeah. Ugh. What a slap in the face. I think we'll go.
More bones return to rest. Devils remanded to their abyss.
Well, humph.
My obsession caused this great foulness, and it is shameful that I must rely upon you to set it right.
You lost 1,000 gold after becoming overcome with emotion and donating generously? What? Better be from your own pocket, sir. Well, 6,000 gold, that's enough for enough things for a medium run. However, I think I'm going to take a quick 5 or so minute break, have a quick snack, refill my drink, etc. We'll see about going for the necromancer. And then after that, I think that'll be the end of the stream for the night, probably. I don't know who to really take, though. We have a spot available. Who do we got here? Oh, look, Antiquarians. An Abomination. Who has everything? What? Oh, some of them being like werewolf abilities or something. I just know abominations. A lot of people refuse to party with them. Not that bad, though. I mean, I'll take him. I won't bring him quite yet.
Tortured and reclusive.
And this that man was, is more dangerous than he seems. Wasn't quite 20, but 16 deeds. 15 of that. More on the stagecoach I could do. I guess that's not really the issue, though. We need to get more people dead. That's what we need. Okay. Taking a break, like 5 minutes or so. Drink, food, etc. Then we'll hit the necromancer. Yeah, necromancer apprentice. For restraining padlock for the abomination.
Ooh.
It's not bad, actually. Bust Dresden when he transforms. Becomes sort of a regular thing for the group. Okay, so back in 5 or so-ish. And I'm back. I do have a Mass Effect series on my channel, Mass Effect 1, though it's incredibly old, and most of Mass Effect 2, though it's also incredibly old and sort of canceled in the middle of it. One day I think I'll probably restart the Mass Effect 2. I think I still know where the save is. Maybe, possibly. If it's there, I don't remember if it's on the dead hard drive or if it's somewhere. Yeah, you really need to stress. Damn. Can I see what paranoid is exactly from here? Jesus. You ain't looking too good, Rogue. Can I take these off you somehow? There we go. Get rid of those. Actually, is there a button that I can just hit and be like, unequip all from people? There we go, unequip all trinkets. Ha ha ha! Fantastic. Best button ever. So, we've got... We need... We need definitely a tank. A couple plague doctors wouldn't go terribly amiss, but do I need two? I don't think so. We'll see. Just throw something together here real quick and go from there. Well, no, you're not really a tank. Baldwin. Welcome back, Baldwin. You were missing for a while. I should see about upgrading your weapon or armor. I will. Herbable's character in-game is like, send me out again. Ugh. Hold on. Yeah, because you both have Plague Grenade, which is fantastic. So we can really just blight them down real quick. You're the Houndmaster who can hit basically anybody, as well as mark targets. It'd be nice to have a bit of a crowd control, sort of a stun type thing. Just to help out, because you just do heavy damage, spamming, intimidate, dodging, and all that. Yeah, the man-at-arms would be so clutch, but you're so stressed. Go for the Hellion, maybe. The Yop, bit of a stun. That's a bit of crowd control, right? Yeah, I know. I don't have any healers, though. Like, that's the thing. I have one. They're crazy stressed. I don't have any of the Arbalists. I don't have any more of them. I'm Generic Carrot is still out drinking. Mass Effect 3 is a great game. People hate the ending of it, but for me, it wasn't really about the ending. I enjoyed the journey. And being able to just, like, carry on progress from Mass Effect 1 and 2 and keep the story going made me feel really bad about some of the decisions that I made early on. It was a damn nice game and a fantastic series. I'm looking to see what they do next. Upgraded the stagecoach. Increase the number of available heroes to 4. Yeah, let's do traveling. That. Do that now. We need more variety.
Stirring in distant cities. We can use this.
Yeah, I agree, Pariah. I really do need a healer. So, okay, so let's head off and bark. Do I need 2 plague doctors right now for a generic mission? Probably not. Let's just do a quick short. Another warrior cap, maybe. Two crit on the jester. Where is the jester? The jester died. Jester's dead. These are like all mediums except these. Okay, so I guess I'm doing something like this. And I think this loadout might be okay just for a small. No blight to Warrens. I get them mixed up. Cove is the one I'd want then, because I thought Cove was the Cove's the underwater one. Warrens is the you fight humans there, undead in the ruins, and then Wield is the mushroom dudes. Right? Okay, let's not bring these guys. Those who have faith don't like you, so not you. We'll try you out. Where do you like being? Toward the front. Okay. That was it. Come hither. That's the ability that I need to unlock with these guys. Jesus Christ. How much is it for if I get it for both of you? 900 per? Okay, we'll make money on this. Yeah, because that's the pull. That's fantastic. That's definitely something that I need. Oh, Warrens is rarely humans. Okay. Okay, because I knew to keep Blight out of the Wield. I wasn't 100% sure about Warrens. Makes sense. Okay, so take out Uppercut, give you Come Hither. Because you're toward the back. We still have you for a little bit of Blight. Blinding gas, all that jazz. We'll bring the Abomination and the Houndmaster into the Warrens. Are we okay with that? Increase the Blight chance, increase the stun chance. Increase your that, I suppose. Do you have any bleeds? Stun. We get anything for a stun chance still? Yes. Houndmaster. Oh. Melee might apply to the dog? Question mark. And I don't know about you. Seems like mostly melee stuff. Melee, melee, melee. That's a ranged beast's bite. In case you get knocked back a little bit. That stuns a dude. Only if you're in the back, though. Okay. Melee accuracy. That's Crusader only, Hellion only. And some bleed resist.
Yay!
We'll try it. Oh god, you guys bring like nothing to the table. Ugh. 6, 8. Couple shovels. And that's it. Well, I'll bring 2 keys. They sometimes pay for themselves.
They breed quickly down there in the dark. But perhaps we can slay them even faster.
Scott, right off the bat. So really all you can do is transform, and when you transform, that's what these abilities are, which is the front row stuff. Got it. Which is the rank for the front two. Rage, which is just a damage thing that's got a higher chance of critting. And slam, which just knockback reduces dodge and speed and all that jazz. That's a really good thing for getting the big tanky guy in the front out of there. Is he worth it for party fudge? What do you mean, party fudge? Sounds delicious.
Rawr!
Everybody else gets a little stressed, but that's fine.
Be gone, fiend.
Damn!
Really? I did it again. Why do I keep doing this?
Executed with impunity. Foolish horrors. Brought low and there. Driven into the mud.
Because your favorite position is in the back. You can't do Hound's Rush, which is why I didn't really want you in the front. Yeah, I don't really have another front line aside from the Abomination currently. Stress management is an issue, but I do have Cry Havoc, and it is only a small ruin type thing, so it's not too terrible. And I'd say it's still worth it if, since you can't bring any people who are like somewhat religious, that's fine. He seems to be pretty dang good. He's level 0 with the most basic equipment he can possibly have. So, oh, God. Fifteen against Beast, 60 against Marked. So, let's go ahead and mark him. Now. Also reduces the protection. So he'll be easier to take on later. Plague Grenade in the back. They have 40 Blight resist, but I also have plus 30 Blight chance. Because Trinket. Go ahead and transform. Rrr. And then probably just Rake. Maybe Slam. You can hit him wherever if you do that. Okay. Go for that then. Bang. Didn't knock him back at all. That's fine though. Thirteen to 25.
Bang. Fuck your mark. Falls,
a faint hope blossoms.
Thank you. I need a lot of things. The jester would be great, though. Thought that did knockback. No, it moves him forward. Knockback two, yeah. Shrug. Must just not be procking. Any cultist, a jester, an arbalist. There's a lot of things that I'd like to have. Both dead at the start of your next turn. Let's go for him.
Give them no quarter.
Get over here, Rar!
Destroy.
He died when he got hooked. Oh well.
As victories mount, so too will resistance. Packs laden with loot are often low on supplies.
Guess we'll loop around.
Such blockages are unsurprising. These tunnels predate even the
earliest. Yeah, and I might not be using the right ability. That's possible. Put a dark trait in it. Damn it. Why didn't that work? Oh, nice. So he's got scouting chance in the wheels, scouting chance in the ruins. He's turning out to be quite the okay guy. Let's do it again. Oh.
Whoa.
Jesus. Okay. This is hell. God. I didn't bring bandages. Damn it. Really? No room bed? Oh, yeah. Fine. Whatever. Giving the abomination everything. Tough too, huh? 10% max HP. Okay. Fuck, I stopped too. Damn it.
Ancient traps lie in wait.
God.
Unsprung and thirsting for blood.
It's a trap ahead. Okay. 90%. 90%. Either one of you.
A handsome reward for a task well performed. Finding the stuff is only the first test.
This place isn't too bad.
Carried home.
Yeah, I will. With a Houndmaster, I can do some of the stress heal, absolution for himself. Yeah. Let's go ahead and do it now. That's fine. I don't need a whole lot because we're almost done. We just have another room battle to go. And target that guy.
Ringing ears.
Critical vomit. He vomited rabies at me. Gross. Give you the damage up because you'll be fighting a marked target. Yep, that's the one. 14 to 28 damage. Bang.
Destroyed.
Go for the stun. And then, not guard dog. Oh, Cry Havoc, I have to be back a bit? Alright. Well, can still go for the Hound Rush. And then I... Does that do any damage? No. Minus 100% damage mod. I guess plug grenade him. Yay. And there we go. GG! Extra GG.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Down to 70, that should be okay. Because even if he goes paranoid at this point, it's not really going to do too much to me. Dude's going to have to go to a stress relief thing in town anyway, regardless.
A
25 gold.
Waiting to be spent.
Wow, a map of the road ahead. The room. Great.
The light, the promise of safety. Another abomination cleansed from our lands.
Do it. Grrrg. God, are you okay back there? Yikes.
Another one falls. Back to the pit.
Okay, quest is over, let's go.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a
let's go quick.
insidious killer.
He's on Death's Door with Blight.
Some experiments should have never happened. You are doing just work ending them.
Eagle Eye, crit for range skills. And just guilty conscience. Okay. Accuracy and scouting chance. Nice.
In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.
Generic Herod has double vision. Great. I suppose as a healer, you don't really need accuracy, I guess. Hopefully we got a new occultist. Okay. And an arbalist. All right. Because the arbalist, Bola is great for knockback to mess him up a little bit. Blind Fire is great for big damage. Battlefield Bandage, though. It's not the greatest heal, but it is a heal. So, let's get rid of... We'll get rid of Howard and make you a Seeker. Well... I gave you the upgraded weapon. How about Feckless? He doesn't have any experience yet. We'll make him an occultist. See you, Akibob. Take care. Have fun with house tours and stuff. Yeah, let's get rid of Feckless and give him the occultist.
It is done. Turn yourself now to the condition of those poor devils who remain.
Night blindness. Okay, no problem. Damage against unholy, nice, and natural swing for more accuracy. Nice. Okay. The arbalist would be a great one to pick up. I'm not sure who to get rid of. You have... Yeah, you've got double vision from the town thing, so I can't really use you. That'd be handy too. That means I wouldn't need these guys. But I think you're probably going to be healing and doing Abyssal Artillery most of the time, so I think you're okay as is. Oh right, you need to level, right? Yeah. Ah well. Okay, so let's see what we've got. Definitely occultist for heals. Sort by class. Definitely. In the far back, doesn't matter. Okay. And then we need a tank, like Baldwin. A Hellion could be handy too. Or God, so much stress. Another Plague Doctor. Howard. Sure. You get good stuff, right? Not just blood. You got plague grenade. Okay. You're not phenomenal. I'd really just be bringing you for the plague grenade, which is really good. Could probably bring you back. Come hither. Collect bounty is quite strong. You can hit the front line with it. Hook and slice for bleed in the back row. Oh, Blight's out. Hey, cool. We got a named group here. Yeah, because you'd basically be spamming Intimidate on the ads that it summons. You going for the hook and slice to try to bleed it the best you can, if that even works, otherwise collect bounty. If... I don't think you'll really get a chance to use that. Abyssal Artillery would be a good thing to have with you. I might swing back and pick that up. Replace, Hands from the Abyss with it. Being able to mark with Vulnerability Hex would be a good thing. Yeah, Rogue brings up a good point. So let's swing back and pick a Vulnerability Hex and Abyssal Artillery. See how expensive that is. I might have to sell some more trinkets. Just buy everything. Oh. Well, that's a good one to have anyway. I didn't need it though. Get rid of Hands from the Abyss, because you shouldn't be up that close. Vulnerability Hex for the mark. A lot of pulls. A Well, let's bring that along just in case we have to clear the corpses and pole's just not working. So we'll do that. And then... Oops. What's going on? Oh. Right click. Okay. I think we've got it here. So we can mark, and that synergizes with the bounty hunter. We are now status mayhem. Sure. It doesn't really matter, I don't think, for my purposes. And then unequip all the trinkets. Give you the... Not bleed skill chance. Well, give you those. Well, plus 15 to heal, sure. And I guess that your speed's a little reduced, but that's always a cool thing to have. And then you. You're basically just straight up damage, so definitely melee skills. And then two of them, damn it. That'll be fine. Give you the other hat. Plus 20 bleed resist. Sure. So healing you is quite a lot easier with the occultist. Because you don't bleed as much. Alright, we're doing it. It's for a very rare martyr seal. You do a lot more damage at death's door, a lot more crit, and you have death blow resist. But you lose a little bit of dodge. Sure. Okay. Let's sell some stuff. Yep, sell one of those. Grave robber only. Yeah, sell it. Crusader only. I don't have many crusaders. Sell that for now. That should be enough gold. Let's do it! All of the food. A lot of the torches. Okay. And holy water.
Mastery over life and death was chief among my early pursuits. I began in humility, but my ambition was limitless. Who could have divined the prophetic import of something as unremarkable as a twitch in the leg of a dead rat?